Dozens right here in the tri-state also gathered in front of the Hamilton County Courthouse following the Chauvin verdict.
WCPO 9 News reporter Kristen Swilly has reaction from those who have been protesting since George Floyd's death last summer and shares what they say comes next.
The verdict was exactly what the people who gathered here were looking for, but they say this is just the first step toward what they consider a more just system and towards getting old cases reopened. While there was cause in this crowd for celebration,
it's actually getting the truth. I think there could be a change. I really do.
Activists say they are not slowing down in the wake of the Chauvin verdict.
The fact of the matter is that as much as this moment is a win, we still have a lot of work to do.
We made this. We pressured this verdict. And if we continue, we can get more of these cases reopened and more prosecutions.
And feelings are mixed.
It was very emotional. It's still emotional.
For Iris Rowley, who played a critical role in the collaborative agreement and guided reform following the death of Timothy Thomas, it's bittersweet.
They saw him and they decided and determined that his life mattered in the court of law. So it gives you a renewed sense of, yes, let's continue the fight.
And while the world marks this moment in history, activists say the fight includes those whose names we'll never know.
We can't shy away from the fact that while a lot of these cases don't get national attention, it does not mean that they are, you know, aren't happening or that they don't need the attention.
Those who were here say their attention now turns to sentencing in the Chauvin trial set to take place in about 8 weeks. At the Hamilton County Courthouse, Kristen Swilly, WCPO 9 News.
Top officials in the tri-state are also weighing in on the verdict. Cincinnati Mayor John Cranley released a statement saying justice was served. Tonight, Cincinnati Police Chief Elliot Isaac said, "I understood the angst that came the days, weeks, and months following the death of Mr. Floyd. As both a black man and a police officer, I too was angry. I encourage the citizens of Cincinnati to please express their emotions in a respectful and peaceful manner."